Hi, I'm Chani Nicholas, and this is Star Power. Today, my guest is Janet Mock, and we're going to see what her chart has to say. And so we have you at the beginning of Taurus. You've got a Taurus rising. Did you know that? That you have?
I did know that because when I read your book, I started looking up all this stuff on your website because you can put all that information in. And so I kind of, I know that. I don't know what it means exactly.
But. Yeah.
Did you resonate at all with it, with anything that you read?
I don't know. Yeah, I guess. Yeah. I guess it makes sense because I feel like visually I don't seem like a Pisces.
Okay, so your sun is in Pisces, obviously, spoiler alert. But Pisces has that kind of mystique to it. Like there's an elusive quality to Pisces. And so when your sun is in Pisces, there's that feeling of like, ooh, it's like soft lighting kind of follows you around.
Well, there's my ring light and my other light. So yeah, it makes sense.
But a Taurus rising, a Taurus is like how we kind of like, it's what we want to be known for. And so while Pisces is like mysterious and like everywhere and nowhere and poetic and creative and like away with the fairies and in the realms of possibility, Taurus is very, very grounded and very here and very solid. And so it wants to be known for somebody who's going to show up and going to be reliable and also going to build something. Taurus is fixed earth, and so there's a way in which when you have Taurus rising, you want to be known for your ability to manifest possibility. Does that resonate with you at all when I say that?
In a way, I guess that probably very early on, both of those sides helped out a lot. You know, I think as growing up, you know, as a trans girl, really thinking about visualizing what my life could be like, who I could be, how do I step into becoming who I am, and the Taurus part of me, I guess, kind of came up with that action plan to make all that happen. So it does deeply resonate.
And then we look at the planet that steers the ship of your life, which is the planet that rules your ascendant, and that's Venus. And you have Venus in a sign that it has a really hard time in. You have Venus in Aries. And so when you see that, there's always a kind of connotation of there might be a struggle around an issue that pertains to gender. And so what I've seen so much with this like almost exact signature is folks that specifically have experienced some part of that. This signature in your chart says, you know, we are not lost. There's beauty here. There's abundance here. There's stories here. This population or my experience has been demonized or criminalized or what have you. But my job is to go into those spaces and say, this is the beauty of it.
To be honest, you know, my television and film career is new. You know, being a storyteller isn't new, but I have been feeling that pressure and grateful to Netflix, really, for giving me a creative platform and home where I can nurture that stuff and incubate these ideas and then make them, you know? And so I do feel like I'm on the cusp of that, of the making of a lot of this stuff, and to stand on my own, as you said, like the authority. And that's really exciting. It's very scary, but it is the next chapter, and it resonates on a very, very deep level.
So on the other side of your moon is the asteroid Janet Song.
What?
There's a couple of asteroids that are named Janet something. Like it's like an asteroid got named after a person. I think you can do that. But this one is named Janet Song, S-O-N-G.
It's so funny. Song, like it's, you know, I got my name from Janet Jackson. That's, you know, like just being very literal about it. It's like,
exactly.
That piece is just like, oh, okay. I'm like,
what?
Like it was listening to, you know, The Velvet Rope and then seeing images of her with her red curly hair and her, you know, expression of her sexuality and how fluid she was through that. And, you know, that made me just feel like, oh my God, you know, that's the name, that's what I want to name myself. I want to name myself Janet, you know.
Yeah.
That's so funny.
So that the universe was like, let's be Captain Obvious about it.